Okay, beautiful. Good morning, everyone. Can I just tell you, I love how so many of you are just like on time and ready to roll. Today is going to be a really big, really special day. So welcome, Valerie. Welcome, Jen. Who else? We've got Amy. We've got Kelly. We've got Carly. Hello, hello. I am thrilled to see all of you today. We're going to give a minute for everyone to pop on. But as people are coming in, here's what I want to hear. What was the takeaway yesterday? What showed up? What was a transformation? You can type it in the chat or you can come off mute. By the way, I know I've got a bunch of DMs from people sharing what has been going on in transformations. And we're just literally, we've got so much coming in this week as a team. So if you have messaged me, I will get back to you. But who wants to share something that shifted? Yesterday, we talked about masculine and feminine and what's that balance in how you show up to your work and your sales and your productivity to achieve the greatest results. So I want to hear from someone here live. Let's see here. Valerie, I'm going to call on you if you don't mind. Yeah, there you go. We're on the same wavelength, sister.
Yeah. Now, of course, coming from a corporate sales background, it's like you're encouraged to do whatever it is to hit quota, of course. But like going into sales, I knew like intuitively that that was not going to be the way that I was going to do things. I had a great manager the first time that I went into sales, who was more hands off and kind of like, let me do that. The second time, not so much. So like, it was definitely hard. But yeah, just sort of the, why aren't you making this happen? You need to be going and making this happen. It's like, I've already like, I've presented it. I think it's coming. I know it's the right solution, and just being confident in that in yourself. So I think yesterday it was kind of like, you were right. Like your intuition was right. You don't have to force the sale. So yeah.
Yeah. Oh my gosh. We've got, and we don't have time for it today, but we've got a beautiful story of a member of the community, who landed the biggest sale for her company. She's out over in the UK. She landed the biggest sale for her company to date by doing that and like listening to her intuition instead of pushing it to try to hit a quota by the end of the quarter. So yeah, you're spot on. It's the both and, right? It's like, it's the both and. That's what we're talking about here. So we use the masculine for structure and support. And then we never want to let that override though, our intuition and our knowingness. So beautiful. Who else? Let's do like one more. What was a takeaway? What was a shift that showed up? I would love to hear. Let's see. Who do I want to ask? Let's see. Amy, I know you're driving right now. You may not be able to share. So if it's not a good time, you don't have to talk. You were muted too. So I don't know if you can unmute. And it literally, if you were driving and it's not a good time to unmute, that's okay. You can just say, you can shake your head no. I'll ask someone. Oh, there we go. All right. Thanks for being here.
So no, I would love to. I think that thing that I resonated with the most was just trying to find that balance between the feminine and the masculine, because I have always been so more in the masculine side. And yeah, it's so nice and so refreshing to realize that there's the feminine side, you know. It's like, I never knew that. And it was just, you know, it feels so good, I think, is what is so good for me right now that I'm getting from all of this. It's just, it's like, it just feels so good to just, I guess, get back to me, to who I am, and, you know, feel like this is okay for me to, you know, rely on my emotions, my intuition, instead of just pushing myself and drilling myself to the point of just so much stress and, you know, it's just been wonderful, very emotional, wonderful feeling. And that's why I just love everything that you do, because it's just, I think it's just hit, you know, it's time for me to hear all these things. So,
yeah. Wow. What I love about, well, I love a lot about what you shared about that, Amy. But it brings me back to when I first learned some of this, and it was such a feeling of relief. And it was like, a lot of it didn't quite make sense yet. And there were still a lot of limiting beliefs about, you know, if I'm going to achieve my goals, I've got to just outgrind and out hustle and like cut off intuition and just do the thing, and working harder is the way to make more money. So I still had a lot of limiting beliefs about that, but there was a knowingness in my body and a feeling of like relief. It felt just kind of what you said about like, it felt like coming home, and it was, yeah. And that's how, you know, like a lot of what we talk about in this community, and everyone's in a different phase. That's part of what I love about this community too. Some women come in and they're, you know, they've been down the spiritual development path, but they're still looking to ascend and go higher. And some of what they're really looking for is more of the tactical strategy, which is a lot of what we're going to talk about today. We have a lot of women come in who have been so in their masculine and so on the tactical strategy side and thinking that it just had to be hard. And when they start to learn these things and realize that they can achieve more success by coming into full alignment with how they're wired and who they are, and that in fact, it doesn't have to be hard, it's like the floodgates open. And two, for that, because we've actually had, this is something I love, and I'll speak to this a little bit more today. We've got a number of men joining in on this summit too, and it's really, really great. And I've been getting some DMs, and we serve, and I love coaching men. I coach quite a few men privately, and I've worked with a lot of men over the years. And when they, again, it's different. It's a different application. But when they start to implement and embody some of the principles we're talking about too, their results skyrocket and it's easier. And they're like, I have more time to do what I want, and I have more success and more money. So all of that to say, this is universal. And there are, for us as women who have been so in our masculine, there's like a homecoming type of feeling I find when we learn this. So thank you for sharing that.
Yeah.
Oh yeah. Okay. So I want to get into it because we have so much to cover today. So today we are covering the fourth quadrant of quantum sales growth, which is method. So we're going to get deep into that. And I think it's going to really help you think differently about the actions that you're taking every day. We have a beautiful client spotlight that we're going to be doing about halfway through the session today, and I can't wait to share her with you. And we will share about our programs that are open for enrollment right now today. We've been getting questions throughout the week, and so today is the day where we're going to share and answer more questions on that as well, and how you can go deeper if you want to. So let's start with, let's get into method though. Let's get into method. Let me pull up my... my share here. All right. Can you all see that? Okay. We good? Okay. Awesome. So this is a quote that I read recently. Now I do not know if, Sherry is the original person who said it, but I read it in her book and I loved it. Mindset plus skill set equals jet set. Yep. That is 100% it. And so it's what I'll actually tell you a little bit about. We're doing a partnership with Sherry and the Bank Method of Selling. Soon, so I'll tell you all more about that here in a bit. But here's what's so powerful is that when you build the strategy and the tactics and the method on top of the big three as your foundation, that's where you quantum leap. So here's how I think about the method. And by method, I mean, again, simply like, what is the strategy that you're going to implement to achieve your goals? The way, there's an analogy that Abraham Hicks uses, which it makes me laugh, but it's so true, because I used to show up this way and wonder like, why am I working so hard, but not getting the results that I want? So Abraham Hicks uses an analogy that like most people go about their action throughout the day as if they were trying to vacuum the living room without the vacuum cleaner plugged in. So you can think of it, it's like you're pushing, you're working, you're moving that thing, but it's not turned on. It's not plugged in. And that's how it is when you apply any sort of strategy or tactic but you don't have these big three as your foundation, it's going to feel like a lot of action. It's going to feel like you're working really hard. It's going to feel like you're doing a lot, like you're busy, like you're doing all the things. But there is a difference, like we talked about yesterday, between connected action and disconnected action. So we're talking today about connected action and how do you build and layer your strategy for connected action on top of this foundation that we've mapped out here this week of the big three. So I think something that is really unique about our community and our programs and what we do is that it really is so holistic. So we talked, again, we've covered the big three like high level this week. But then in terms of the strategy, there's a lot of, and I'm really big on people finding the right alignment for them in terms of coaching. And there's a lot of people out there who just teach strategy. There's a lot of people out there who just teach the inner work. We are very comprehensive because I think you need both in order to succeed. I really do. So on the strategic side and on the tactical side, I think our team is the best in the world, some of the best in the world at what we do here. So I'm just going to share a little bit of background. I personally have sold millions of dollars and coached virtually every industry. So sometimes people say like, well, is this for, who is this for? I'm a coach, I'm a consultant, I'm in corporate, I'm B2B, I'm B2C. I've coached and trained them all. I've coached and trained them all, literally thousands of sales professionals and entrepreneurs. I've been privileged to work with and coach people like the number one rep for Salesforce, eight-figure entrepreneurs, million-dollar producers, New York Times best-selling authors. If any of you are into podcasting and you know of Lewis Howes, I've been privileged to work with him, and also entrepreneurs and sales professionals earlier in their journey who are just starting out. And Laura, who is doing more and more work too with our clients, and she's brilliant and talented in all the ways. So it will be such a privilege if you get to connect with her. But she is an expert at, I would say, everything sales process related. She does very high-end transactions and has literally done 9-figure deals and has managed upwards of $1 billion in deals over her career. We were chatting about it this morning. I was like, you are a freaking powerhouse. So all of that to say, it is the both and that we're talking about here and that matters. Because all of our clients are so unique, everything on the method side is very customized to you and to what you're doing and to your specific industry and goals. But what I do want to share is that there's these three core elements of method that are universal that matter no matter where you're coming in from and what your background is. So let me pull this up. I'm calling them the three B's. All right. So the first one, you have to believe. Believe it or not, the most important thing with whatever strategy you implement is that you believe it will work. Again, our clients are in so many different industries, coaching, consulting, financial services, mortgage, real estate, B2B, B2C, tech, IT, AI, direct sales, network marketing, like you name it. We have served people in those industries. What matters most, because there are strategies that you can implement and hear others doing in any industry that work for them, but you have to believe that it will work for you. So this is part of why we do so much of that foundational, tactical, and strategic work on the mindset at the beginning, because you need to know how to clear your limiting beliefs about yourself and how to be successful. So if you have a belief that you will only make money if you work hard, then guess what? Whatever strategy you pick is going to feel really hard. And by the way, this is not true. If hard work is what led to money, construction workers and stay-at-home parents would be the wealthiest on the planet, right? They would be the wealthiest on the planet. That is not the way to create the most money. But if you have a belief system that it is, then it will feel like you have to work really hard for what you're doing. Or if you have a belief system that you could, like this was my belief, that I could never launch a group program and that a bunch of people wouldn't want to work with me. I had that belief system. I had to overcome that in order to successfully launch a group program and build what we've built today within the company. And once I overcame that belief and started taking the actions to build and launch a group program, everything quantum leaped in my life, but I had to first believe it was possible. How many people have ever had the thought like, oh, I'm annoying people when I reach out to them? Like you get a killer script to use in DMs and you're like, I'm going to reach out, or you've got a great phone script, depending on what your sales process is. But if you have a belief that people don't want to hear from you and that it annoys people when you reach out, you're going to have that experience. And then one of my favorite ones in terms of belief is the, like, I'm special. And I had this one too, where it's like, oh, that will work for somebody else, but it won't work for me. And so that is ego. All right. So we have to learn to tap into when is our ego trying to hold us back from taking an action that would actually serve us and get us to where we want to go. So the I'm special one, or almost everyone's ego does that to them. Everyone's ego does that to them at some point. And that is also a limiting belief. But what I do think is so important with the method is choosing something that's aligned for you. Choosing something that's aligned for you. Let me stop the share so I can see here. Mary, are you okay if I use an example of what we mapped out for you on our recent call? Okay. So Mary's in private coaching with me, and we were on a call. I don't know what call this was, last week, week before. And in Mary's industry and in what she does, a lot of people use webinars to sell, and there's nothing wrong with that. I like using webinars. I like using online conversion events. Here we are. Like, I enjoy it. Mary does that and is good at it. And she also has a superpower, which most people don't, in her space of doing in-person events and speaking with people in person and hosting them live. And so we were really tuning into, for something that she's launching, like, what would be the most aligned and what felt fun to her and light and easy. And it was just, my feeling on it, and Mary, you can affirm or whatever here, but my feeling as we were talking about it was like a webinar felt so heavy, and the thought of doing something in person and fun and unique felt light and felt easy and felt effortless because it was so aligned with your skill set. And so I truly think that is so important. In choosing the method is knowing that you don't have to fit into a box that wasn't meant for you in order to be successful, and you can pick what's in alignment with your gifts. I was working with one of our mastermind members recently on her strategy too, and she thought that to hit her sales goals, she was going to have to just cold outreach and DM people. And not that I haven't done that, and I think we've probably all done that in some way, shape, or form in our businesses, but it was feeling so heavy to her. And sometimes that's just a limiting belief we've got to work through. But as she and I were talking, it was like, no, she actually has this amazing superpower of being able to go out and build corporate partnerships. And then from those partnerships, get in there and start serving all of their clients and use a really leveraged approach. So for her, the thing that made the most sense to do, and the thing that was actually strategic and felt aligned and felt fun, was to go out and start building corporate partnerships and then get positioned as a consultant for their clients. So I say all of that to say, again, it's about believing that it'll work, and it's knowing that you can craft a method and create a method. And that's something that our team helps with as well, that's aligned to you and your natural gifts and talents. I firmly believe, and I know, if it feels hard, if it feels heavy, if it feels like a grind, it is not going to be successful for you. So the key is we want to tap into what is the lightest, most enjoyable, most effortless way. And usually when we find that, kind of like Amy so beautifully said before, there's almost this like, oh my gosh, like I can actually be really successful and make a lot of money, and it doesn't have to feel like such a grind. So yes, the answer to that is yes. And that's how you know that you're in alignment and that you're mapping out and building and working with a method that's actually going to get you to where you want to go. So the second, let me go back into my share here. The second B of method is about building. Now, this is so critical, and this will make you think differently than you've been thinking in the past. So you're going to build out your method based on where you want to be, based on your goal, not based on where you are now. This is so important. So a lot of times our clients, when they come into our programs and they start doing both the inner work to rewire limiting beliefs, and then they also start thinking differently about the actions they're taking, they'll come to us on calls and be like, my mind feels like I've been doing like mental gymnastics all day. Like they're thinking so differently about what they're doing. And that's such an important piece of this. So this is all about decision-making and action from the end result, which we'll keep talking about today. So building from the end result, looking at, I'm just going to give some examples. Let's say you want to hit 10K months and that's your next goal. What would the version of someone who is hitting 10K months in your industry be doing every day? Let's say you want to hit 50K months, 100K months, $1 million months. I don't care what it is, but you have to build your daily method of operations and your daily success habits based on your goal, not what you've just been doing. So this is so important. So let's say too, like your vision is leading a team. Right? The things that you're going to be doing every day as a CEO and as a leader are different than the things that you would be doing every day as a solo producer or a solopreneur. Or if your vision is you're in corporate and you want to like crank it out in corporate and do amazing, and you want to be number one on your team, the things that you're going to do there are going to be different than what you're doing right now if you're not currently number one. So you want to look at what would someone who's number one be doing? And then that's also where we're going to tie in the mindset piece. So what would they be thinking? Oh, they wouldn't be thinking I can't do it. They'd be thinking like, this feels really good to be showing up in this way. Like this feels really good to be so successful. How would they feel in their bodies? They'd be really confident. They'd be calm. They'd be relaxed on their conversations with prospects. So again, this is all about embodiment, and it's about you becoming the version who has your goal, the version of you who has your goal accomplished in all areas, thoughts, feelings, and behaviors. So what's really beautiful about this too, is that as you scale and elevate, and this has been my experience for sure, like it's not about more action. It's not, it was actually less action on my part to hit 7 figures in sales than it was to stay stuck at 6. When I was stuck at 6, I was taking a lot of action and I was overwhelmed and I was tired and I was, it was like I was vacuuming without the vacuum cleaner plugged in. When I decided that I was going to step up and see who I was as a woman who was capable of building and leading and growing a company, and not just the company, but like creating a life for myself and my family and creating impact that I wanted to create. When I decided that I was available to do that and to say yes to that calling and that mission, the types of actions that were required were, they were very stretchy, but it wasn't busy efforting action. So I was doing things there that really challenged, I still do this every day, just in a different way, because I'm going for a different goal now, but I was doing things that challenged the old version of me, but it's not about just more of the same. So for example, I had sang previously and in school, and I always loved singing, and it was just not really something that I did more, primarily because I had a pretty traumatic experience in college and experienced sexual assault, and the next day had to go do a solo performance for our college choir, and I botched it, and it was like, it was terrible, and I felt so much shame and so much embarrassment, and so I'd stopped singing after that. And when I decided to go all in and I invested in myself and invested in mentorship at a really high level as part of that declaration of I'm going all in, my mentor challenged me to sing publicly on social media. And it was so uncomfortable. And I was like shaking and nervous and sweating. And it was like an out of body experience. But I was so committed to breaking past the old chains and the old limitations that I did it. And you would think, what in the world does that have to do with growing your sales? It had everything to do with growing my sales, because in that moment, I reclaimed a part of my power that I had given away. And I started showing up as a much more confident, much more empowered woman than I had been before. as well, you know, I shared too, like launching a group program, like part of my journey was I had to get out of the old belief system that I couldn't powerfully lead a group of people because I had that belief and put myself out there and offer group programs. And to this day, like our group programs are beautiful and I love them. And I love working with incredible women in our community, and building that community there and seeing them thrive. But so again, the action is going to be different than what you're doing right now, but it's going to be that next level stretchy action that actually gets you to where you want to go. So I want to just give you a moment here before we go further to stop and think about for the vision that you have. And I want you to tap into, we're going to keep coming back to this today. Who is that fullest expression of you that you connected with on day one? And if you weren't here for day one, that's okay. All I want you to do is think about your current goal, right? Why are you here? What are you creating? And then we're going to take like just a minute because we got a lot today, but I want you to just think, what are some things every day that that person would be doing? Now we're talking revenue producing. So we're not talking busy work here. Okay. We're talking revenue producing, things that would actually move you towards your goal. What are, let's try to land on 3 to 5 core things that someone who has achieved the goal that you want to achieve would be doing every day. So I'm going to go silent and you take a moment to reflect there. All right. I know we're all busy thinking. I'm curious too. I'm going to keep going, but if any of you want to share in the chat something different that you would be doing every day, I'd love to see that from you. And my team would love to see that from you too. So here's the thing. So this is called either building out like your daily method of operations, or I call them my daily success habits. So I have things that I do every day that help move me forward in the business. I also do this, daily, weekly, monthly, quarterly, depending on what I'm focused on. But those things are going to require you to skill up. So think about this based on what you wrote down there and what you mapped out, where would you need to grow? So is it you need to step up in leadership? Is it that you would need to get really great at marketing and promoting yourself? Whether it's on social media, whether it's on podcasts. I love helping clients launch podcasts and I've done that a lot. Is it your sales skills? Is it you'd have to get really comfortable sitting with people and helping them overcome limiting beliefs on sales calls about working with you? Is it public speaking? So whatever it is, when you quantum leap, you are always going to be required to skill up. And that's awesome. Because again, it's part of this ties back in with yesterday. The actual gift in that is you are going to be so proud of yourself for who you've become in the process of skilling up. So it's all about how you get to grow along the way. But that's a core component of the method is you have, let's say like 3 to 5 things that you do every day based on your goal, not based on where you are now, that are going to help you get to the goal. So you're going to start thinking like a different person and showing up like a different person as you do this. So the third and final of the three here, let me share my screen. All right. Is you're going to behave. The third B, behave. This is about implementation and execution. Don't y'all just love it when something works out with either like an acronym or something where it's all the same letter? I don't always have that happen, but I was like, yeah, this is, It's a lot easier to remember that way. So the three B's. So you're going to have your daily method of operations, right? Based on your goals and where you want to go. And here's the key with it though, is you actually have to do it, right? You actually have to do it. This is where there is a choice. And this is where people get separated in terms of people who actually achieve the goal versus don't. I find that if people don't have that foundation of the big three that we've laid this week, it is so easy to get stuck. And you can know something, you can know that this is something that would be really good to do for you to accomplish your goal, but you find yourself not doing it, right? How many of us have had that experience? Like, it would be a really good idea if, you know, whatever, I don't know, if you are an entrepreneur and you want to call in more clients, like, it might be a really good idea to have a podcast. It might be a really good idea to do a live stream. It might be a really good idea to go to a conference and speak about what you do. But when we have a foundation of limiting beliefs about who we are, what our identity is, what's possible for us, you're going to feel fear, you're going to feel resistance, and you're not going to do them. You're not going to do them. So this is why we build on the big three. We want to dismantle the limiting beliefs. All right. And again, by the way, it's like, it's not your fault that those are there. I want you to know this. It's not your fault that those are there, but once you're conscious of them, it is your choice if you're going to continue living in that cage or not. All right. So these things have been planted subconsciously since before you were even born. That's epigenetics. It's been planted subconsciously since before you were born. And once you wake up, your job is to decide that you're not going to stay there anymore. If you want to grow, if you want to have a different experience. So we got to dismantle the limiting beliefs that would hold you back from behaving and executing based on what's going to get you to your goal. We want to build a new identity of you as the person who has your goal achieved so that you can actually start to live into that. And your subconscious mind can feel comfortable with you stepping up and showing up in a different way every day. And then from that place, you're taking action as the person who already has your goals achieved. And it feels, again, stretchy, but it's also going to feel fun and exciting. And it doesn't feel like efforting. If it feels like efforting, it's not going to get you there. All right. That's something so, so, so important to know. So when you're taking action from this place, you're not in your head second guessing about whether it's going to work or what someone's going to say. You're connected to your goal and your vision. And I found, and this is how I love showing up every day now. It's like, it's so much more about who I'm becoming and me showing up as the best version of myself every single day and giving myself that gift than about trying to force or push an outcome. It's going to feel fun. It will feel light. It will feel uncomfortable. So that's important to know. When you are stretching, when you are growing, that any sort of actions that you take that are very comfortable for you are not going to grow you because they're in your present comfort zone. So this is so, so, so important to know. So there is a difference between something feeling light and fun and exciting versus something feeling comfortable. Does that make sense? So if you keep taking actions based on your present comfort zone, you're not going to get different results. So your comfort zone will become a cage for you. And that's why we want to be so conscious of that. You have to take action and make decisions based upon what you want, not where you are. All right. And this is something I practice, like I'm in it with you. I'm uncomfortable with you. Laura knows we were chatting this morning. I made an uncomfortable decision this morning. It's like, it's uncomfortable when we're growing. It's uncomfortable, but that's how you know that you're actually growing and on the right path. So these are the three B's: believe it will work, build based on your goal. And then you got to behave. You got to behave as if. So I want to do a client spotlight right now on a beautiful member of our community, Jen Mauerman. Jen, do you want to unmute and say hi? I'm so excited to share your brilliance and your gifts and your genius with the community. How are you? It's so good to see you.
I love this material. This is always such a good refresher for me too, even though I feel like I'm constantly in your programs.
It's always, well, and to that point, like we were talking about this yesterday, there's always another level. Like these are the core principles that apply no matter what you're looking to achieve. And there's always another level that we get to go to and apply it with. So yeah, you and I have known each other for years. I love you. I'm so happy to see you. You've been in, a lot of our pro. So you did 10K club. We've done VIP days. You're at Sedona. You did our retreat. You're in Meet the $1 Million You right now. So do you want to share just a little bit about like what was going on in your life when you came into the She Sells community and why you decided to participate?
Yeah. Oh, absolutely. Well, obviously there's been very many different levels, and it's funny that you say that because my voice is kind of hoarse again, which kind of similar to a level sometimes is your voice. Mm-hmm. And, so for me, it was, so even taking a step back from there, I had known Elise like through brand builders with, working my personal brand. And once my time was done there, she had launched this, I think it wasn't too long after, but I remember when you started talking about your message on She Sells, I was like, holy crap, that really hits home for me. Mm-hmm. And, you know, we had the discussion and I took the leap, the best leap I've ever taken for sure. But for me, it was I was really more into at the time, the tactical side. I was like, I want to learn to grow all this stuff. I honestly didn't even understand the inner work part. And so once I started with you and we dug into that, at first I was kind of like, what is this? And that's common. Was like, I trust Lisa, I'm going to do the work. There were so many blocks I had that I had no idea even existed. I didn't even honestly know that was a thing. And we worked through a lot of stuff. I even signed up for an intensive at one month. Cause I'm like, I'm really understanding this now. I want to understand at a deeper level. And so what I've loved about being part of this community is not only the work during it, but I love just even how supportive you are, like in the in-between times too. Mm. Like you're always giving us resources, podcasts to listen to, all of the different materials. So what brought me in originally was the tactical side, and it's the inner work that's completely been the transformation for me. Mm. And the tactical side is easy.
Yeah. I love that. What's been the biggest transformation for you?
Yeah. this is kind of a fun one for me because it was of course unexpected. But I was in corporate America for a long time. And it's so funny because we talk about masculine and feminine energy, and I missed yesterday's call, but the masculine side, not only have I been working with my masculine side for so long, I'm in the beer industry. So you can imagine that brings a whole other layer of masculinity.
You're like the one woman in the industry.
Yeah, for sure. And I was in that for a long time. I moved to a different company, and when my time was done there, I was working with Elise already. And I was like, I know I want to be an entrepreneur, but I don't know exactly what I want to do. And so she put me through this exercise, which I found really powerful, of you don't need to know what the business is. Like, what do you want? Like, what do you want out of, like, if you were to own your business, like, what are some of the attributes? And so I was listing them down and I was holding them, you know, close to my heart, meditating on them every morning, embodying that feeling of what that would feel like. And I'm not even kidding. I got a call out of the blue from a former colleague at Anheuser-Busch. That was the company I worked for a long time. She had moved on, you know, a couple years before, and I got a call from her out of the blue. She's like, hey, we're looking for someone to run this department, which was one of my intentions. We are a fast growing startup, so not corporate America, one of my intentions. She's like, we are a really fun company. I was like, one of my intentions. I want to work for just a really fun company. And literally 2 days later, I'm on a plane to Austin and sitting with the co-founders at a beautiful steakhouse. And I left with an offer in hand. I didn't even touch my resume.
I that. That is manifesting.
And hit my salary requirements. And even beyond that, it was more. So I, the benefits were like the 100% health insurance coverage doesn't come out of my paycheck. Mm-hmm. I got stock for the company and they're not offering that anymore because we're growing so fast and getting so many new people. So like, it was just even what I wanted and more. And while I still know I'm meant to be an entrepreneur and have my own thing at one point, this is the perfect place for me right now. And I'm even creating, you know, I'm on a different level now than I was when I started, leading a team of people. And I have bigger goals now for us and even, you know, more financial goals too. So working on a new up level within this current season that I'm in. Yeah.
That was so good. It's so, so good. I forgot you'd done that without a resume.
Yeah, I know. I'm working with I still have my old like let pass jobs on. I still haven't touched it.
That's the power of alignment though. Yeah. And being clear, that's the power of the inner work. And it's like, you still had to take the action. You still had to show up and do the thing and take the action, but it was on this foundation of the big three that you didn't even know were like running the show for you previously, limiting you in ways you didn't know were limiting you. So when we transform that, everything shifts. What would you say? So I would love to hear, final question for you, Jen.
Yeah.
What would be like your top advice for someone who's here this week and they're like, I'm feeling it. This, like, I know I want to grow. This is speaking to me. And they're thinking about investing in themselves and going deeper in our programs, in our community. What would you say?
Yeah. Besides do it. Like, I just want to say I've been there before. I was there, obviously. So for me, yeah, the financial piece like stuck out to me at first. And then when I did the math and understood like different ways you can go about, you know, paying for something like this, it wasn't even about the money anymore. I challenged myself. I was just kind of sitting there and I'm like, well, what's going to change if I don't do this? And I was really honest with myself and was like, nothing. Like I'm not holding myself accountable. Like I don't understand like the next steps. How am I going to grow like into the version of me that I want to be if I don't take action and if I'm not saying yes to something that's really speaking to me. So that's really what it was for me. And the financial stuff came later and in abundance more than I thought it would. So I can't speak for everyone, but learning the different tactics through this process, like meditation, like embodiment, all of this stuff. I've gotten raises, I've got unexpected bonuses, I've got unexpected checks in the mail of things I kind of forgot about. And it really comes to you when you open yourself up and are open to this and really apply the materials.
Yeah.
And that's been my experience. So which is so why cool. I will keep investing in this. Yeah.
Oh my gosh. I love you. Thank you for sharing. And it's so true, like what you shared. And I always tell people like, you don't bank on this, like, so to speak, but we have so many community members. Once they say yes, they either like sign a client the next day, that's the full amount they needed, or they get an unexpected check in the mail. It's just like, we talked about money, on day two, and like your job with money is not to micromanage the how. Like, money comes in after we make the committed decision in the most convenient way it can come in for you. That's how money works. So that's so beautiful. Love you. Thank you for sharing. You're amazing.
Thank you for having me.
Yeah, absolutely. So let's do this. I'm going to take you through a guided visualization, and I'm really excited to do that. I think it's going to be really beautiful and really powerful. I do want to take just a bit here and share more about our community, how to get more involved if you want to take your work deeper with us. And like I said, we've been getting a fair number of questions and email and DMs. So we will also share how to hop on a call with us after this to answer your specific questions. But I want to take a minute here and share what we have open for enrollment right now and how we'd love to support you if you want to take your work farther. So here's where we're at, right? So we just spent the past 4 days together diving into this four-part framework that creates quantum sales growth. And you hopefully know a lot more now than you did coming into the week. And what is so true though, is it is one thing to know something. And like I said, I knew stuff for like 10 years, but I didn't apply it and I didn't get deep coaching in it and I didn't embody it. So it's one thing to know it. It's another to be it. and understand how to implement it to create a quantum leap in your results. So what I would say, as we talk a little bit more about our programs that are open right now, which are the 10K and 50K club, you know, if we went through everything this week and it didn't really speak to you, or you're like, you know what, I don't want to transform right now. I don't want to change. That's okay. Like, that's totally okay. It's probably not a good move for you to move forward in investing with us to help you transform. Like, it wouldn't be worth your time or your money. If you were listening and it's speaking to you and something is resonating and you're feeling something inside of you, it would be a good move to have our team help you customize and apply this to your own situation so that you can become a different person with a radically different reality in a relatively short amount of time. And I think this is the power of coaching. I'm always working with a coach. I usually work with multiples depending on what my goals are. We just show up differently when we're investing in ourselves. We do all the way down to yesterday. I was working out and, I mean, this is like not a big investment at all, but I've got a workout app that I use and I pay a little bit of money for it every month. And, I pushed myself so much harder because I was working with the coach in the app. Then if I was on my own, I would have quit like, you know, 5 minutes in, because it was really hard. So because I had that coach pushing me, I pushed myself and I got different results, and I'm really enjoying like getting really strong and healthy right now, in my life. And so I'm seeing those changes because I'm showing up differently and I'm invested. So again, it is very different to understand intellectually what it takes to get quantum sales growth versus having it customized and applied for you. And so that's what we do with our programs. So in high level, and this is for all of our programs, because we have group, we have private, we do have some courses as well. But everything we do is built on that foundation of the big three. And then the strategic method is layered on top. And then from this foundation, it's just like I can't remember what day I use this analogy on, but it's like, if you want to build a skyscraper, you have to have a strong foundation for it. So that's what we're doing here. So from that foundation of really up-leveling in those three areas, so your mindset and your self-concept, money and worthiness and receiving, tapping into the feminine magnetism that you naturally have that many of us don't ever tap into or we've cut off. From that foundation, we layer the tactical on top, which creates explosive growth. So you can expand in insane ways from there. Something that I do think is so important though, and this was critical in my journey, and it's something that I teach our clients too, is the way that we're going to do this and the way that we're going to work with you is from a place of wholeness. So a lot of times we try to achieve a goal from a place of I'll be good when, or I'll be worthy when, or I'll be successful when. You're actually not going to, if you achieve it, you won't be happy. You won't be satisfied. You'll still be experiencing self-doubt, limiting beliefs. So this concept of selling from wholeness that we've really developed within the community is when we do that inner work of the big three, you love yourself. You love yourself and you love your life and you love your business or your career, regardless of the results. And then from that place, it's more about, let me see how much I can expand. Like, let me see how epic my life can get. Let me see how big my business can get. And that's something that I had to really learn, because I spent a lot of my life not loving myself and not even realizing it. And I was so self-critical and so hard on myself, and I would push myself and make myself wrong. We don't do that. It's not that. I'm not a slave driver. It's like, we're going to help you really connect with how amazing you already are that you've just forgotten. And then from that place, we're going to help you expand and grow to experience the sales and the business and the revenue results that you're looking for. So it's very different. I do want to take a moment, because I'm very conscious of who's in my energy and who's in the team's energy. And so I always hope no one takes this the wrong way. But because we do work so deeply with our clients, I want to just share, before I share our programs, like, what is a requirement for us and for me with my clients? Number one, you've got to be ready for the transformation. So you have to be ready to do the work. you have to be ready and willing to have a different experience, not just of sales and business, but of your life and of yourself. You have to be willing to drop the attachment to old limiting beliefs, to old patterns, to old ways of being. You need to be empowered or ready to be empowered. You know, like I said, we work with quite a few women in our community who have gone through challenging backgrounds, and not everyone has, but a lot of them have. And we honor where you've been, and we are all about you elevating. So if someone is attached to staying in victim mode or attached to that, we're not the right community or program for you, and that's okay. People who are decisive, people who take action, willing to show up for yourself and others, you got to be coachable and you got to be self-accountable too. So if that's not you, again, that's totally fine. And I hope you've enjoyed this week, but I don't think it would be a good fit. If that is you, then we would love to take our journey deeper with you. So with that, we do have two beautiful programs that are open for enrollment right now. And we've got some special bonuses too that we're doing right now for those of you who say yes to investing in yourselves. One quick thing I will mention again, because I've gotten a number of DMs from men this week who are like watching quietly or on the sidelines. Men, we love supporting you. We love helping you. So we do have options for the men out there. And like I said, I love working with them. Send us an email. You can just email me, elise@elisearcher.com, and we will help you and hop on a call and talk through how we can support you. These two offers I'm about to talk through are specifically for women or those who identify as women, just because of some of the vibe of the programs. So the 10K Club is, and you can look at it. Actually, if my team can pop the links in here now, that would be so helpful. 10K Club is our signature group program for women who are ready to break through six figures. And so with that, you can be an entrepreneur, you can be a sales professional. It's a 12-month incredible journey that we take you on, where you have twice monthly live calls. You've got an incredible training suite that deep dives into all four of these four quadrants and teaches you how to actually apply this and how to implement everything. We work with you on the calls to customize this and help you apply this for yourself. You get a retreat ticket, which is so fun. Jen mentioned she went to Sedona. Who here has been to a She Sells retreat? I see some people who have been. Are they not so much fun and like life-changing and transformational? And I think that's something else that's really, really so fun about this community, is that it is a community. So we as women have often been taught that we have to do things alone, or we can't trust other women, or we can't lean on other women for support. And that's something that I'm really committed to shifting with this group. And every single woman in this community is there for each other. We are there for each other. And it's so, so powerful. So I would say a few things with this program. And again, thank you, Laura, for popping that in. EliseArcher.com/10K Club. You can go learn more about that one. Currently, so as of right now, for those of you who are enrolling now, it includes a 30-minute private call with me. I don't know if we're going to offer that again. It's very possibly the last time we're going to offer it. And then the other pieces, I don't think I've shared this with my team, but I'm feeling called to convert this to a shorter program. So a 6-month program for women who are joining later in the year, but it's going to be at least the same investment. So right now you can get in at the invest, it'll actually probably be more. So you can get in at a lower investment and be with us for the full 12 months as the program is right now. So that's 10K Club. 50K Club is our high-level mastermind. And that's for women who are already at the six-figure level, who are ready to scale to multi-six or seven. And I created this because I loved being in community and supporting women who are already at a level of success in their careers, where a lot of people are looking to them like, you got it all figured out. You clearly are like, sometimes you feel like you have to have it all together all the time. Like your community, your peers are looking at you as their role model, and that's beautiful. And we can also sometimes feel shame or guilt about wanting to expand even further. And what I wanted to create was a community of women who were unapologetically going for more and supporting each other in the process, and a place where women can come in and be like, I don't know how to do this, or I'm struggling with this, or I'm bumping up against this, and where you're supported in your desire for expansion, and not feeling like you have to stay small in a box that other people think is expansive and big. Like as you keep growing and elevating, your vision will expand and you will be ready for more. And I wanted to create a place where women could experience that. So with that program, that includes everything in the 10K Club. That also has two additional calls per month. So with me, we bring in very high level guest mentors to come and work with that group. We've got a group chat between calls. So there's a lot of access in that program. So you come in and you can connect with the other women throughout the week. I'm there every single day checking in too. So that's just way more access in that program. There's also an exclusive retreat just for our mastermind members as well. So those are the details on that. I want to share the, Laura, can you pop, thank you so much for popping that in. Can you share the funding link as well if someone needs support around funding? But what I do want to share is the bonuses that we're doing right now. Okay, there we go. So bonuses with these programs. So right now, so there's two different ways that you can get involved if this is resonating and you want to go further. One is on both of the pages, it does give you the ability to just enroll directly. You can also book a call. You can also book a call if you want to talk with me and my team. We're here today, tomorrow, and Monday to meet with you and help you, you know, decide and navigate what the best path is for you. For those of you who enroll by tomorrow at, is that the right date? Yes, 9:29. By tomorrow at 11:59 Eastern, we're going to bundle in our course, Create Your Quantum Leap. It's $777. You're going to get that for free. I am also going to be hosting a private workshop for our clients a little bit later this fall. And that's going to be all about the impression of increase in sales. And it's going to be really, really beautiful and powerful. So you'll get that too. By the way, if you're on this and you're a current client, you're going to get that too. So just know, like, you'll be invited to that. Then for those who choose to enroll by Monday at 11:59, you won't get the course, but you'll get the workshop included as well. And then for anyone, we do have payment plans on all of our programs. For anyone who does paid in full though, I will do a private coaching session with you. And that's on 10K Club, 50K Club, or private mentoring. You'll get an additional private coaching session. So with that, the next steps, again, if you are like, this is speaking to you, you can apply and enroll directly through the program pages. I put that in there because if you're like me, I'm someone where if I know something is for me, I'm like, I just want to do it. I don't want to have to take the time to like schedule a call and hop on and talk through it. I'm a fast action taker. I just want to do it. So that option is there. Our programs are application only though, because we are so conscious of wanting to make sure that it's a really good fit for you and for us. So after you enroll, if you do it just straight through the website, you're going to get an application. And it's an intake really, but it's going to ask you a number of questions to help us best serve you. And so my team and I will review that. If for any reason we think it's not going to be a good fit, we just let you know and we give you your money back, like no big deal. But then if you do want to hop on a call and have us, you know, have us talk through this with you and help you figure out what the right path is for you, then you can do that too. And those links are on the program pages to book a call. Laura, I'm not looking at the chat, but maybe just pop the link for the calls too in the chat if you can. So that's that. So those are the next steps. I'm looking at time and I'm like, I could probably go until 12:30 Eastern today with how much more I have for you. I want to, here's what I want to do. Let me check with my team. Let me stop the share and check with my team, because I want to do the visualization for you. I have more I wanted to talk through with the programs as well. So does everyone have a hard stop at the top of the hour? I'm definitely going to get the visualization in. Okay. I was like, if anyone wants to stick around, I can stick around a little bit longer. I don't even know with my team. Or we can come back tomorrow. Like we're going to come back tomorrow anyway, and we'll have time for implementation. Let's do this. Let's close with a visualization. Okay. I'm going to help you connect with the highest version of yourself, with all of your goals accomplished. And what I would say with that is the best and most powerful way to make decisions for yourself towards your growth is decision-making from the end. So just like you build out your goals based on who you want to be, or you build out your daily method of operations based on who you want to be and your goals, I also am going to encourage you and tell you that the very best way to make decisions for yourself about how you invest in yourself and what you do is saying, with my end result achieved, what would I do? What would I have done? All right. That is always the thing that will get you to your goal. So let's connect with that version of you. Let's help you tap into her. If someone on my team, maybe Laura, you can listen for the sound because I want to play some music here. Let me share my screen. One moment. Okay. Okay, good. Just give me, Laura, give me a thumbs up if it sounds okay. Can we hear okay? All right, awesome. So wherever you are, I want you to close your eyes and take some breaths. Breathing deeply in, deeply out. I want you to now see yourself in the vision that came to you as the fullest expression of yourself. Who is that fullest version of you? Notice who you're with. Notice what you're doing. Notice how you're celebrating. What are you celebrating? Notice how you're dressed. Notice how you're holding yourself. I want you to now notice who else is benefiting because you said yes to you. How are you feeling? Wherever you are, I want you to go find a mirror. And look in the mirror and tell yourself how proud you are of yourself that you listened, that you took that action, that you decided to drop your limitations, that you chose to take this one precious life that you've been given and show up as the fullest expression of yourself. That you chose to ascend. That you're creating a legacy for yourself, for your family, for future generations, for the world. You woke up. You chose you. And you're living your impact in your greatest possible life. Breathe that in. That already exists. I want you to remember right now that your desires are green lights. As Bob Proctor said, if you can see it in your head, you can hold it in your hand. And all you have to do is say yes. When you're ready, you can open your eyes and come back into this moment. So with that, I will leave you with this. Trust yourself. Trust what showed up. Make decisions based on that. Okay. My team and I are here to help support you. So we will meet again tomorrow. Tomorrow is our bonus day. I'm going to be doing a lot more live work with each of you, which is going to be really, really fun. And we're going to just go deeper into everything we talked about. I didn't get to do much of a Q&A today on our program. So those of you who are hanging around a little bit after, thank you. And we'll do more of that tomorrow. I can talk more about everything. But I would say if they're resonating and if you want our support in helping you actually become what you saw in that vision, we're here. And we do have some time just this afternoon, tomorrow and Monday to chat with you. And, or like I said, you can enroll directly in the program most appropriate for you if you feel called through those program pages. And tomorrow we are going to announce the giveaway winner too. So we're giving away a private coaching session with me. Again, to be entered into that, you need to do the homework every day and show up live every day. So yeah, you got to be present tomorrow to win. The homework for today is share what showed up for you in the method section. So what are the 3 to 5 things that the version of you at your end result accomplished would be doing every day? So share that. And then again, you'll get double points for the giveaway if you want to share what showed up for you today and tag me on social. Tomorrow, same time, same place, we're going to bring this home, and I'm really excited to connect with all of you on achieving your vision and your goals. So much love. I'll see you tomorrow. Bye-bye.